Inside this wooden case we have a Britannic calculator. It is the only brand of pinwheel machine that was made in England. It was made by Guy's Calculating Machines Limited, based in Wood Green in London, and it was made from about 1919 until the 1960s. Frank Guy learned all about mechanical calculators when he was an insurance clerk. And then he became a calculator salesman. He would import calculators from Germany and sell them on the British market, mostly Mercedes Euclid machines. When the First World War broke out, the supply, of course, dried up, but he had ideas on making his own pinwheel machine. With funding from British Petroleum, he set up Guy's Calculating Machines, and then started building these pinwheel calculators and supplying British Petroleum with them. Any surplus he could sell on the open market. It was a very small operation. He only built 2,000 machines in the first 15 years. His machines were distributed through other salesmen like Remington and Moldevo. Moldevo also was an importer of machines from Germany. In 1939, when the Second World War was about to break out, Moldevo bought Guy's calculating machines in order to secure a source of calculators. Under Moldevo's control, the production was stepped up and many more calculators were produced. After the Second World War, Moldevo started to import machines again from Germany, mostly Walter calculators. And Guy's calculating machines slowly started to turn into more of a precision engineering company. By the end of the 1960s, Moldevo could no longer compete with electronic calculators, so they sold off Guy's calculating machines, but that didn't help. In 1971, they closed. I'm not sure what happened to Guy's calculating machines after that. This machine has number 1462, so was probably made at the end of the 1920s. It seems an apprentice had a hard time stamping the serial number. This machine is remarkably small, but still has 18 digits in the register, so it has a high capacity. It has a unique mechanism for moving the carriage. This allows you to move it any amount, whereas this is for moving it one step at a time. If you enter a number like this, you can add it as usual. The wing nuts here are to clear the register. And this lever is to clear the input. Unfortunately, it's missing the knob on this lever. The way that works is that each of these input pins, or these discs, also has a pin at the back. So when you move this lever, it actually engages with those rear pins that are now hidden and moves those along. Let me open it up. Here you see the input pins. These are the carry pins. Here is a big spring for this lever. And this here is the bar that moves the input pins back to the start. It pushes these pins back. And here is the pin that increments the counter. There it is. This front plate has this groove in it here to give room for this pin. This was the Britannic pinwheel calculator. Thank you for watching.